babe. I'm really excited about meeting your family for the first time and spending the holidays with you guys. What? Nervous? No. Why would I be nervous? I have nothing to be nervous about, right? Yeah, they're gonna love me, and I know I'm gonna love them, okay? So, yeah, I'll see you guys tomorrow. All right, bye! What am I gonna bring? If only there was something quick, easy, I could just walk in with my hand. Hi, I'm Chanel, and welcome to the very first episode of Partners in Wine. What is Partners in Wine? Well, aside from being an actress, a writer, and a content creator, I'm a huge wine enthusiast. Yeah, I know, it sounds like I have a problem, right? Maybe we should call somebody, but it's true. And, you know, this show is going to bring together three of my favorite things: wine, my friends, and saving a buck, which I think is the most important part of it, because you know you can get a good bottle of wine nowadays from anywhere between $12 and $30, and that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna drink, we're gonna learn about some wine, we're gonna have some great conversations, make some friends, talk with some old friends, and have a great time. So let's get started. Wine choices for common holiday situations, or as I like to call them, lituations. We've enlisted the help of a fellow friend and wine enthusiast extraordinaire, Miss Tira Johnson. Tira, where'd you come from?
Oh, you know, just the floor.
Hi, Tira. How are you doing today?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm good. And guys, so Tira is not just your regular, common, you know, Trader Joe's wine store wine enthusiast. No, she's got the receipts, she's got the paper, she has been a sommelier at a bunch of hot restaurants here in New York City. She is currently studying for her level 2 SOM exam, which is taking place next month in Toronto, so send her positive vibes to pass that. And she currently works at ABC Restaurants with the John George's Group in their beverage program. So Tira's here, she's got the knowledge, she's here to help us. And so, Tira, as you know, the holidays can be very stressful, right? With your family, your friends, people that you like, people you don't like. And so we have all these common holiday situations that we need to bring some wines to. So the first common holiday situation, we would say, would be if you're going to a friend's holiday party. And in particular, friends that don't particularly like wine, or they think that it can't get you buzzed for whatever reason. And you know who you are, those friends out there. Okay? So what kind of wine do we have to answer those for those friends?
So I was thinking Lambrusco.
Ooh, Lambrusco.
I feel like a lot of people forget about Lambrusco.
I did.
So Lambrusco is a it's a Frizzante styled wine from northern Italy. It's pretty much the red wine version of Prosecco in a way, or chilled. And I don't know. I just feel like it's a great one, especially to bring to a party with friends, because there's some people that don't really like red wines, you know, and they tend to like whites or vice versa. And I feel like this kind of hits the mark on everything. And then it's also sparkling, you know, so
sparkling.
It's the holidays. You need something to celebrate.
So let's try it. So, you know, Tira, I also would like for you, for those of us at home that might know how you're supposed to try wine, you know, or the technical version of how you're supposed to try wine. So first we're going to pour some out.
Thank you.
Oh, look, it's so fizzy and sparkly. All right, so what do we do first?
So the first thing when tasting wine, you want to look at the color. Do it, just kind of put it, I mean, unless you're really like investigating the glass and doing like blind tasting and such like that, you can look at it in more detail, but just to admire the color. You want to swirl the wine.
Okay.
You don't need to go crazy, just in it, what it does, it opens up the wine and the aroma, so you're able to get more. So just do a little swirl like that, and then put out like a 45 degree angle to your nose, and then you just take a little sniff.
Oh yeah.
And you know, just taking some of the aromas. So what do you get off the nose off of this wine?
I'm getting a lot of like, you know, like cherry.
Yeah, like
deep cherry.
Yeah, like black cherries. Maybe, you know, maybe some like raspberry bushes.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe some cranberry. It's the holidays.
Cranberry. Guys. I actually do get a little bit of cranberry. But yeah, no, it's just so you can get the aromas and everything. Mm-hmm. And then after you get the nose, take a sip, and this is where the fun begins.
Yes. The part we've all been waiting for.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh. I always drink Lambrusco around the holidays. I never know why.
Yeah, it's a great
I wish I drank it more during the summer, but yeah.
And, you know, to get back to, you know, what we're also talking about, not breaking the bank here on this wine, this is a great wine and a great price point. It was, I think we got it for $11.99 at our local Trader Joe's wine store. So, you know, I'm sure it's going to be a similar price point wherever you can get it. Moving on to our next common holiday situation, which is the office party.
Yeah.
Iconic holiday office party. You know stuff goes down at the office party. So what is the wine that you chose to bring to this situation, Tira?
So I had to think hard about this one because there's a lot of different situations. Well, I mean, first off, your boss is there.
Yes.
But you're with your coworkers and you're actually letting loose, which, you know, you're not normally doing. So I thought rosé.
Yes.
Why not?
Rosé all day. I'm so happy that you chose a rosé. You know why? Because we are here to debunk the myth that rosé is just for the summertime. Rosé is all year round. 365. Look at Tira's sweater. Slay all day. And then what?
Rosé.
Exactly. And can we talk about this style of rosé, Tira? You know?
Yes. So, so we got this bottle at Trader Joe's. It was $6.99, which is insanely good. But yeah, no, it's a lighter colored rosé, and I feel like it's always best to choose a lighter colored rosé because a lot of people think that the darker the rosé, the sweeter it is. That's not necessarily true, but when you're talking about cheaper rosés, that can be very true. So I feel like sticking with that Provence style. So this is done, this bottle here is done in Southern Rhone, which is right by Provence, and it's the same grape varietals, Grenache, Mourvèdre, Cinsault, and it's a great bottle.
And you particularly love this brand, right?
Yes, yeah. When I saw it at the store, I was like, this is it. When I was in the Hamptons this past summer, I got magnums of this pretty much every day.
Magnums. So if you can only imagine, this bottle was $6.99, so imagine what a magnum costs, okay? So let's go ahead and get to tasting. Yes, that lovely pale pink color.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Oh, God. Yeah. This is bringing back memories. Yes.
They do say that sense of smell is the strongest sense linked to memory, so taking us back to the Hamptons in summertime, a warmer time.
Yeah, I mean it's a rosé. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know,
and who doesn't want to feel that year round, guys? Come on,
it's dry. It has that bright, like peach and like I don't know citrus notes and such. And you know, it's rosé. That's all it is.
Yeah.
It's just rosé. You don't need to take it seriously. You're at an office party.
Yeah.
You know?
This is going to be a hit. And you're going to be, you know those office parties. They start early and then they last till the wee hours.
And you need something to carry you on.
Yeah.
Hitting the tequila right away,
No, we do not recommend that.
No.
We've been to the friends party. We've been to the office party. Now we're on to the big one, which is meeting your significant other's family for the first time at a holiday situation, okay? And so what wine did you think would go well for that situation, Tira?
So I chose a Châteauneuf-du-Pape.
A what to what to what? Did you sneeze? What did you just say?
Châteauneuf-du-Pape.
Châteauneuf-du-Pape. Okay. Yeah.
It is it's a wine from Southern Rhone. It's Grenache-based. Also has a little bit of a blend of Syrah and Mourvèdre in it. First off, it's a fun wine to say. It sounds fancy,
right?
And the bottle does
Shut
too.
To pop. Look at this bottle. This bottle is beautiful.
It was great. We got it at Trader Joe's for
$19.99, guys. Yeah,
which is really fantastic for a Châteauneuf, actually. Mm-hmm. I feel like you can please that father who could potentially be a wine snob because they are out there, and they can be intimidating, especially if you're the new person that's being introduced to the family. But I also like it because it's, it has structure and it has a nice body to it, which would definitely please someone who likes Napa Cabernets or, but it also has a nice acidity and it has a brightness to it that I feel like would also please Pinot Noir drinkers as well.
Like moms love Pinot
so
Noir.
So I feel like people that love Napa wines and wines from California will really enjoy this. And I also think people that tend to go for more old world wines like myself will be very, very pleased with.
So that's what we're going for here. We're going to impress. We're going to, you know, impress that wine snob. We're going to impress anybody. Just by the fact that you can say Châteauneuf-du-Pape, you're going to impress somebody. Okay, so let's go ahead and taste it. All right, here you go.
Thank you.
All right.
Yeah, so you could see from that color, it's just like, it's a gorgeous color. And the nose.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
oh,
right? Yeah. The nose, there's like a... There's like an earthiness to it.
Pepper.
Yeah, there's a pepper, but there's definitely like a little bit of fruit, but it definitely has a lot of these like earthy, like peppery notes to it. It's beautiful, right?
Yeah, it's so silky.
Silky. It has those nice silky tannins, like really well integrated.
And can you talk for just quickly about a tannin? What is a tannin for those at home that might
So,
not know?
Tannin is this like mouth drying sensation that happens in your mouth. It's you know, like when you drink a Cabernet, those can tend to have bigger tannins and such. How I usually have people resemble it to is over steep tea. Have you ever left a tea bag in your tea for like half an hour and forgot about it, and then you have a sip of it, it's like an Earl Grey, and it's like,
yeah,
you feel like a cat, like you're just like ugh. Yeah, so that's what tannin is.
And so there you have it, guys, our festive wine choices for common holiday situations. All the info for all the wines that we try today is going to be in the About section of this video. Also, feel free to please comment and subscribe if you like what you saw today. And if you have any suggestions for a future episode of Partners in Wine, we'd love to hear from you. So please send a comment down below as well. Our special thanks today to our guest, Tira Johnson, who, sidebar again, is studying for her level 2 SOM exam. Okay, so please send her good vibes. And you can follow her journey on Instagram at Something Between. That's SOM like sommelier with 2 M's. Something Between. My Insta handle is at Chanelio, so at Chanel, my name, with an extra L-Y-O. Please like both of our pages. And so, Tira, I just want to end by asking you, what are you doing for the holidays?
I'm going to be in New York. My brother Lars is going to be visiting. So,
yeah,
family,
fun,
lots of wine.
Family. And you know what, on that note, I just want to pour us a little bit more so we can cheers to that family, fun, and lots of wine.